My name is Zailda Chan, and I'm the president of Unite Here Local 40. Last week, the CBC invited a member of our union to speak on live television to talk about the economic impact of the pandemic on workers like her across the country. The hospitality industry has been hit the hardest, with over 90% unemployed, and will be the last to recover. We support Nym Calvez, who said what many workers in our industry have told us. While we appreciate Trudeau putting money into our pockets right away, $2,000 is not enough to live on for more than a few months, whether you have a family to support or you're on your own. This economic reality affects all communities. Workers of all backgrounds have expressed the same concern. $2,000 is not enough. Before the pandemic, workers were already living paycheck to paycheck in one of the most expensive cities in the world. These economic pressures have only worsened during this crisis. Why should we feel ashamed to tell our stories as immigrants, as women, as working people fighting for a better life? In fact, more people, more working people, should be telling powerful politicians what we need to get through these economic crises. I have come to learn of extremely hurtful and offensive language towards Nym. I am deeply troubled by the hateful nature of these remarks. This is unacceptable. How can we remain quiet while thousands of hospitality workers went from having a steady job to having no income overnight and will remain in this situation far longer than any other industry? Together, we will support each other. We will speak out. We will continue to fight for a better future for all hospitality workers. Thank you.
Yes. Well, in this moment we're live and we have Nym, who is one of the organizers of the rally in front of the Hyatt. Can you tell me, how do you feel about the event of today?
It's awesome. It's great. We have so many supporters. The workers are very happy. They feel the support, and we're very thankful for all the community and other union allies.
For those people that don't know what are they asking, the hotel workers, can you tell me what exactly are the things that the hotel workers are asking in this moment through this strike?
Yes. Number one is our job security. If we have no job, we have no future, we have no lives. The second one is we need workload reduction. We're killing ourselves there every day to do the job, and it's too much. We said enough is enough. And of course, number three is we want safety. We don't want to kill ourselves. We don't want to injure ourselves every day working such a heavy workload. And the company just wants to talk about money. It's not about money, because what they're going to do is they're going to give us money wage increase, and they're going to cut our jobs.
Now tell me, how are corporations responding to this strike? Do you think they are scared at this point, or they still tough? How's your sense?
Oh, they're terrified. All the managers are doing a job, is exhausted to the ground, and then too bad for them, because they're in salary, they don't get paid with extra hour. My coworkers yesterday took a video of our HR and all of managers doing our job, and I feel so sorry for them. It's too bad. I'm like, oh God, I don't know how you guys gonna last long. I have a feeling after a week they're gonna be dead tired, or some of them is gonna be like, okay, I'm gonna look for another job or something. It's just too much.
One
of the reasons why we're striking is we want the management to experience our job. How
exactly.
We do it every day.
Exactly.
This is what we do every day.
Yes.
Let's see how you feel.
Exactly.
You're working for 1 week and you're dead.
That's great. Why anyone who's not a hotel worker should be invested in this strike?
Because this contract is going to change the city, it's going to change the industry, it's going to change the lives of workers. We're not just asking for money. Of course we need money. This city is so damn expensive. We can't keep up with anything. But we're trying to change our lives. We're trying to get quality jobs. We're trying to to change our family's life. We're trying to change our future. And it's good. I know we're winning. We are winning. We're very strong. And once we get this contract, it's going to expand to all the industry.
I always say that this movement is going to open a wide door to all the social movements because this is a breakthrough.
Yes.
So, Nym, thank you so much for talking with us, and please keep us posted. We're here to support.
COP
always support any movement, any strike.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.